Hi, this is Charlie Thongpa Huzacha from KT Getaways Dream Vacations. Thank you for visiting my YouTube channel. Join me in this video, we will show you the full ship tour of Carnival Mardi Gras, one of the newest ship from Carnival Cruise Line. We are going to work our way from the top of the ship to down below. Deck 19 is where you can find Bolt, Ultimate Sea Coaster, the first roller coaster at sea. Strap in and zoom your motorcycle-style speed machine around an open-air course high above sea level. Loft 19 Cabana and Pool. Soak up the sun all day from the comfort of a lounge chair or Loft 19's own infinity whirlpool, or opt for private time in the shade by renting a cabana. Carnival Waterworks. For those who flock to water parks just ready to make a splash, there are three different water slides to choose from. They all had unique traits and were a lot of fun. Hundreds of feet of spiraling awesomeness that starts you off high in the air and gets you down low with one of the fastest, wettest rides you'll find anywhere. While Power Drencher takes soaking seriously. Imagine the biggest bucket of water you've ever seen, raining down on you from above. And this isn't just kids' stuff. The young at heart are encouraged to zoom and splash around too. Serenity Adult Only Retreat. You'll still be on the same ship as the kids, but it will feel like an adult's cruise. The Adults Only Retreat allows you to easily forget the Carnival-style excitement. Sports Square. Take on friends at mini golf. Battle strangers at basketball, or push yourself to new heights at our ropes course. Or to record-setting low times at the jogging track. The Warehouse. High-tech video and arcade games are available at the warehouse. There are no age restrictions and it is open 24/7. Teens and adults can definitely find some fun games to enjoy here. Club 02. Hangout spot for teenagers 15 to 17, where you can do stuff like watching movie, playing sport, listening to music, video games, or karaoke. Circle C. It's the onboard spot where teens ages 12 to 14 go to hang out, meet new friends. Unfortunately, we didn't get a chance to take a look inside this time. Guy's Burger Joint. Located on deck 17 midship. Take a big juicy bite of the best burger at sea, brought to you by celebrity chef Guy Fieri. Open from 11:30 a.m. to 6 p.m. In my opinion, the burgers served here are definitely better than average. Good job, Guy Fieri. Red Frog Tiki Bar. Sip a Polynesian punch, try a jungle bird, or get a little tongue-twisted ordering a Red's Rum Jumper. This poolside bar actually spans two decks from deck 16 to 17 and no matter where you are sailing, can be counted on to transport you right to the land of Tiki. Beach Pool. Main swimming pool area with hot tub, loungers and a bar. This is the spot where the Sail Away event takes place. People here will be dancing and having a great time. Blue Iguana Cantina. Looking for taco, burrito, or fresh-made tortilla? Go to Deck 16 midship. They open from 11:30 a.m. to 3:30 p.m. This is definitely the place to get your taco fix. Lido Marketplace, located on Deck 16. If you are looking for a variety of foods, buffet style, served in a casual atmosphere, this is the place. It's okay, not overwhelmed, not sure if it's back 100% yet, but we don't see as much selection of foods as we thought. But still a good place to grab something to eat real quick. Street Eats, located on Deck 16 midship. Street Local Eats has three different vendors where you can grab a quick bite during the day, which consist of Steam Dream features favorites like bows and buns. The second vendor is Mad Sizzle, put the skill in skillet with the like of Lomo Saltadu and Pad Thai. And the last vendor is Time Fries, serves up every cruiser's dream. Fries loaded up with culinary creations from chefs like cheesesteak fries. Seafood Shack. Seafood Shack's the place to cast your net. Imagine a New England-style seaside spot where you can take it all in, enjoying a great meal, complete with a side of ocean view. Tides Pool. Salt water pool on the aft of Deck 16 with two whirlpool spas. Lounge chairs, umbrellas, and beverage service is offered. Deck 8. Atrium. The entrance to the ship and to vacation itself. It is your first impression of all the fun to come. The very heart of the ship screams welcome aboard the fun. With multi-level panoramic views, the atrium gives you the perfect place to enjoy all the hustle and bustle. There's always music playing here, whether it's a live band or a party-pumping DJ, plus enjoy events throughout the day or a drink at the bar, anytime. Guest Services Desk. The place you go if you have questions for one of our certified fun experts, about just about anything that's on your mind. Bar Della Rosa. Bar serving both indoor and outdoor patrons. Thinking of Aperol Spritz, Bellini, or Espresso Martini? You can find them here. And you can also get a perfect cup of coffee here. Bonsai Sushi. Onboard seafood and soy sauce spot. Dine amidst expertly pruned bonsai trees while enjoying sit-down service and an affordable menu of delectable sushi and sashimi. Bonsai Teppanyaki. The teppanyaki chef's attention to craft is front and center, in fact it's right there at your table. One part meal, one part performance. Definitely make lunch or dinner reservations, because this intimate restaurant gathering seats just 16. Chi Bang. Delicious Chinese and Mexican traditions in the atmosphere of this elegant, modern spot. Located on Deck 8, and they open both lunch and dinner. Cucina del Capitano. The iconic red and white checkered tablecloth in your neighborhood Italian trattoria means you're in for a certain kind of dining. This onboard Italian restaurant inspired by our Italian captains and officers' childhoods. It's all served Famiglia style. Guy's Pig and Anchor Smokehouse / Brewhouse. The Barbecue Hall of Famer is bringing some big-time meats like championship pork butt, smoked round of beef, smoked andouille sausage and his famous blue ribbon chicken, as well as rockin' sides like Mac Daddy Mac and cheese, old-school potato salad and collard greens. Throw in his signature line of barbecue sauces and you've got a rockin' sea day on deck. Heroes Tribute Lounge is a good place to chill and watch sport games. There are comfortable leather chairs and two large big screen televisions here. You can also order some drinks from here. Patio Pool. Outdoor pool area overlooking aft of ship, served by the patio bar. Piazza Panini. Located on Deck 8. Open from 12 p.m. to 10 p.m. Their pressed panini was really good. We highly recommend it. Pizzeria del Capitano. Located on Deck 8. Freshly made one by one straight out of the oven with authentic Italian flair. Open from 9 a.m. to 4 a.m. If you aren't asleep by 4 a.m., this is the place to get your late night pizza. Rudy's Sea Grill. This restaurant is the brainchild of cookbook author and master chef Rudy Sodeman. He has years of experience pleasing palates of vacationers, and this guy loves serving up a smile as much as Carnival does. But he's serious about you experiencing the best that the seas have to offer, and an evening at Rudy's proves it through the courses. Enjoy selections like seafood bisque and crab-stuffed lobster tail imperial. The Watering Hole. A poolside bar we're building for aficionados of backyard-style relaxation. Alchemy Bar. Unique vintage-themed cocktail pharmacy. All you need is a willingness to be surprised, to try something new. Select spirits, fresh juices, infused syrups, spices, and other tantalizing secrets performed before your very eyes by the true mixmasters, our bartenders. Choose a remedy from the menu, or let us prescribe you a custom elixir just for you. Fahrenheit 555 Steakhouse. Experience an unforgettably delectable evening at Fahrenheit 555. Their menu features mouth-watering premium cuts of beef cooked to your exact specifications, as well as a fantastic selection of seafood, entrees, gourmet appetizers, and an extensive wine list. The elegant yet modern atmosphere pairs remarkably well with Grand View Bar. If you want to get a drink during the show or games at the atrium, Grand View Bar is here for you. Limelight Lounge. Venue for live music, karaoke, late night shows, art auctions, comedy. Mardi Gras Casino. They have both gaming tables and slot machines. Mardi Gras Theater. Span to two floors from Deck 6 to Deck 7. Two-level main theater hosting production shows from the ship's entertainment staff. Palm Restaurant. This is the main dining room. It spans two floors from Deck 6 to Deck 7. You can take an elevator or walk up the stairs. Drop in daily and enjoy a rotating menu of delectable favorites like steak, lobster tails, or shrimp creole. Deck 6. Cherry on Top. A candy store on the ship. You'll find this well-stocked candy and more store not only great for enjoying some of your confectionery favorites, but the place to pick up food and apparel gifts for that special someone. Cloud 9 Spa. Escape to a world designed, from the ground up, for relaxation. Cloud 9 Spa staff are masters trained in the craft of simply helping you chill. What's their secret? Massages, facials, body wraps, thermal suites, and more. Plus, the amazing hydrotherapy pool, these are the tools of the trade. And the trade is ultimate relaxation. Cloud 9 Fitness Center. There's no excuse not to hit the gym when you are on vacation. That's what Carnival is implying when they have this state-of-the-art fitness center on board the Carnival Mardi Gras. Emerald's Bistro 1396. Mardi Gras sets sail with Emerald Lagasse's first-ever restaurant at sea, Emerald's Bistro 1396 trademark. Everybody knows about Emerald's love for Creole cuisine. Sharing his hometown favorites with the world is his life's work, and now you'll enjoy the authentic bayou flavors and fun that New Orleans is known for on your vacation. Flamingo Restaurant. This is another main dining room. We were assigned to dine here once when the Palm was fully booked. The menu is exactly the same as Palm Restaurant. Fortune Teller Bar. If you've had the pleasure of strolling New Orleans French Quarter in the evening, you're not alone in the feeling that mystery and surprises lie around every corner. Carnival has its own tribute to this Crescent City neighborhood aboard Mardi Gras, and a French Quarter zone on a new ship wouldn't be complete without an unassuming little bar that feels like it's always been there. Java Blue Cafe. From the simply caffeinated to the simply sublime, nothing satisfies your coffee craving like Java Blue Cafe, featuring fun twists on the hot and cold drinks you enjoy. While the coffee is the main event here, there's some other things that already included in the cruise fare, such as panini sandwiches or empanadas. Piano Bar 88. Piano bar and lounge, located portside near the atrium. Features live piano music and sing-alongs. The Brass Magnolia. You can imagine this onboard bar at the intersection two of NOLA's most enduring icons, the city's indelible jazz nightlife and its historic garden district. The culture is well represented on board by the swingin' jazz trio that keeps things nice and hot, and it only takes one look at the decor to feel as if you just stepped into an elegant southern estate. The Punchliner Comedy Club. Features some shows that are family-friendly and some adult-only. You can choose which ones you attend. To help plan your evening, check the fun times. Camp Ocean is the daycare on board. Dr. Seuss Bookville. The room is all decked out in bright colors, featuring fun and whimsical furniture, and even has some of your all-time favorite Dr. Seuss characters on the walls. But let's not forget that this space is all about the books. The shelves are filled to the brim for hours of fun reading. Family Harbor Lounge. This is an exclusive spot for Family Harbor stateroom and suite. Featuring breakfast in the morning, snacks throughout the day, plus activities like board games, family movies, video games, and more, open from 6 a.m. to 9 p.m. using your sale and sign card to enter. There is no such thing as a perfect ship. Carnival Mardi Gras is no exception. We had a few problems with the premium internet package. First, it took us some time to figure out how to connect the computer to the internet. To get connected, you would have to first visit login.com and enter your credentials. Be rest assured that you will be able to switch between devices. The speed is a bit slow, and we got disconnected a few times during the day. The download speed we tested is around 15 megabits per second. Upload speed is around 1 megabit per second. For people who had to work during the trip, this was a big deal. There also seems to be a restriction when uploading to websites such as WeTransfer or Google Drive. We could not upload a video and had to upload one at a port. The Carnival Hub app is pretty neat. The app is very useful and can provide information such as events currently happening at the moment, your overall spending on board, overview of the itinerary, the ship deck plan, what restaurants are open at the moment, and the menu. Restaurant booking system on Carnival is pretty good. You can go to the app, choose your preferences choice of restaurant you want to eat tonight, and just one click. The app will show your approximate wait time. Sometime it only took under 10 minutes or so. It may take up to 30 to 45 minutes during peak hours. In the meanwhile, you can wait around at the bar nearby, grab some drinks, or you can even wait in your cabin until your table is ready. Most of you are probably aware that bringing in iron is prohibited. When sailing, we normally use release wrinkle sprays, which work excellent. But if you want your clothes to be perfectly neat, there are several self-service ironing rooms for you to use located on several stateroom decks. Let's talk about embarkation and disembarkation process. Once we get to the port, we left our luggages to the porter right in front and simply entered the building. The embarkation was smooth and well organized. Once you pass the security check, there will be a waiting area. When you are able to board, you will be informed using your designated group letters. We were waiting here at the waiting area for less than 20 minutes to get into the ship. The muster drill was very quick and easy. Just make your way to the crew members who are waiting to check you in at your designated muster point. There will be a quick demonstration and safety protocols. You are then free to explore the rest of the ship. The disembarkation process was organized and simple. Simply go to the specified luggage tag pickup locations if you want your bags transported off the ship. Choose from the available options the time window that best suits you and grab that tag. Put the tag on one of the handles with your contact information written on it. Personally, I think the tag didn't look secure. But we did not encounter any problems. Then place the luggages in front of your cabin last night of the trip before 9 p.m. Everyone had to leave their cabin at 8:30 a.m. for our trip. We took the rest of our belongings and waited until our time at Lido Marketplace while enjoying breakfast. This ship has the first roller coaster at sea. Bolt, the ultimate sea coaster. Strap in and zoom your motorcycle-style speed machine around an open-air course high above sea level. Plus some amazing 360 degrees ocean views. This ride isn't included and it will cost $15 per person. Carnival Waterworks. For those who flock to water parks just ready to make a splash, there are three different water slides to choose from. They all had unique traits and were a lot of fun. Hundreds of feet of spiraling awesomeness that starts you off high in the air and gets you down low with one of the fastest, wettest rides you'll find anywhere. While Power Drencher takes soaking seriously. Imagine the biggest bucket of water you've ever seen, raining down on you from above. And this isn't just kids' stuff. The young at heart are encouraged to zoom and splash around too. Sports Square. Take on friends at mini golf. Battle strangers at basketball, or push yourself to new heights at our ropes course. Or to record-setting low times at the jogging track. The Warehouse. High-tech video and arcade games are available at the warehouse. There are no age restrictions and it is open 24/7. Teens and adults can definitely find some fun games to enjoy here. Punchliner Comedy Club features some shows that are family-friendly and some adult-only. You can choose which ones you attend. To help plan your evening, check the fun times. Piano Bar 88. Piano bar and lounge located portside near the atrium. Features live piano music and sing-alongs. Join the sing-along for a hand-clapping, foot-tapping, finger-snapping good time. Mardi Gras Theater. Span to two floors from deck 6 to deck 7. Two-level main theater hosting production shows from the ship's entertainment staff. Grand Central is located at the center of Carnival Mardi Gras. This space hosts events such as bingo, live music, games, and shows. It's a very lively spot among the ship. This is also the place to catch the Carnival Mardi Gras parade. Another lively spot on this ship is definitely Lido, located on deck 16. This is the spot where the sail away event takes place. People here will be dancing and having a great time. An event worth mentioning is the 80s Glow Party. It's an experience I will never forget. Sing and dance to 80s tunes with the cruise director, the Flying Scotsman. Heroes Tribute Lounge is a good place to chill and watch sport games. There are comfortable leather chairs and two large big screen televisions here. You can also order some drinks from here. Cloud 9 Spa. Escape to a world designed from the ground up for relaxation. Cloud 9 Spa staff are masters trained in the craft of simply helping you chill. What's their secret? Massages, facials, body wraps, thermal sweets, and more. Plus, the amazing hydrotherapy pool, these are the tools of the trade. And the trade is ultimate relaxation. Cloud 9 Fitness Center. There's no excuse not to hit the gym when you are on vacation. That's what Carnival is implying when they have this state-of-the-art fitness center on board the Carnival Mardi Gras. Loft 19 Cabana and Pool. Soak up the sun all day from the comfort of a lounge chair or Loft 19's own infinity whirlpool, or opt for private time in the shade by renting a cabana. Serenity Adult Only Retreat. You'll still be on the same ship as the kids, but it will feel like an adult's cruise. The adults-only retreat allows you to easily forget the carnival-style excitement. Beach pool. Main swimming pool area with hot tub, loungers, and a bar. This is a saltwater pool and it is 4 feet 9 inches deep. Tides pool. Salt water pool on the aft of deck 16 with two whirlpool spas. Lounge chairs, umbrellas, and beverage service is offered. Patio pool. Outdoor pool area overlooking aft of ship served by the patio bar. Let's start with the main dining room. Palm Restaurant. This restaurant spans two floors from deck 6 to deck 7. Palm Restaurant was our assigned main dining room for the trip. We mostly ate here. The ambience here is very nice and cozy. And Flamingo Restaurant, located on deck 6 midship. These two are the main dining rooms, and they serve exactly the same menus. Here is a list of the meals we enjoyed at these two restaurants. Blackened pork tart. Cream of mushroom soup. Cured salmon candied tomato. Broiled lobster tail. This will be complimentary on formal night, depending on your itinerary. Coffee cream cake. Barbecue pulled wild boar. Baked meatballs. Fried mozzarella. Salmon coulibiac. Broiled strip loin steak. Bitter and blanc. Double roasted pineapple. Steamed mussels. Alligator beignet. French onion soup. Wild rice gruyere and country chicken soup. Supreme of poulet farci. Shrimp creole. Apple pie. Praline cake. Crab cake. Clam chowder. Grilled jumbo shrimp. Filet mignon. Again, this will be at no cost on formal night. Shebang. Located on Deck 8. A dining exploration that invites Chinese and Mexican cuisines to the table. Explore delectable Chinese or Mexican selections from either side of our menu and stretch your culinary wings. We only had a chance to experience lunch here this time. And here's what we had. Wide noodle stir-fried beef. And rice noodle in a broth with shrimp. Cucina del Capitano. Located on Deck 8. This Italian restaurant, inspired by Carnival's own Italian heritage, Delizioso. Open for lunch from 12 p.m. to 2 p.m., and dinner starts from 5:30 p.m. to 9:30 p.m. This is one of the options if you wanted to move away from the crowded main dining room. And here's what we had. Cured tuna. Mussel and clams. Rucola cracked farro salad. Chicken parmesan. Short ribs. Maple ricotta fritters. And tiramisu. Please note that large parties of 8 or more have to contact the restaurant host one day prior. Pizzeria del Capitano. Located on Deck 8. Freshly made one by one straight out of the oven with authentic Italian flair. Open from 9 a.m. to 4 a.m. If you aren't asleep by 4 a.m., this is the place to get your late night pizza. Piazza Panini. Located on Deck 8. Open from 12 p.m. to 10 p.m. Their pressed panini was really good. We highly recommend it. By the way, we had number 12, Carne. Guy's Burger Joint. Located on Deck 17 midship. Take a big juicy bite of the best burger at sea, brought to you by celebrity chef Guy Fieri. Open from 11:30 a.m. to 6 p.m. In my opinion, the burgers served here are definitely better than average. Good job, Guy Fieri. Big Chicken. Located on Deck 16. Opens from 11:30 a.m. to 5 p.m. Step up to the counter for lunch and walk away with your choice of chicken sandwich, crispy chicken strips, or juicy fried chicken baskets. We really enjoyed the fries at Big Chicken. Blue Iguana Cantina. Looking for taco, burrito, or fresh-made tortilla? Go to Deck 16 Midship. They open from 11:30 a.m. to 3:30 p.m. This is definitely the place to get your taco fix. Lido Marketplace. Located on Deck 16. If you are looking for a variety of foods, buffet style, served in a casual atmosphere, this is the place. It's okay, not overwhelm, not sure if it's back 100% yet, but we don't see as much selection of foods as we thought. But still a good place to grab something to eat real quick. Street Eats. Located on Deck 16 Midship. Street Local Eats has three different vendors where you can grab a quick bite during the day, which consist of Steam Dream features favorites like bows and buns. The second vendor is Mad Sizzle, put the skill in skillet with the like of Lomo Saltadu and Pad Thai. And the last vendor is Time Fries, serves up every cruiser's dream. Fries loaded up with culinary creations from chefs like cheesesteak fries. Open from 11:30 a.m. to 5 p.m. Guy's Pig and Anchor Smokehouse / Brewhouse. Located on Deck 8. A friendly place where you can get variety of meats from the grill. Here's what we chose. Sausage. Beef, mac and cheese, and collard greens. And if you have late night munchies, you can find late night snacks here. Java Blue Cafe. Located on Deck 6 Midship. As you can guess, you can get your coffee fix here. Only some of the items that doesn't have price tag are included in the cruise fare. Swirl's Soft Serve and Froyo. There are several of these located on the ship. They are open 24 hours and are self-serve. Last, Tea Time. We are not sure if they have this every day or not, but we got to try these on the last day of our cruise. Open between 3 p.m. to 4 p.m. We definitely can spend the whole trip without spending a dime on the Mardi Gras. There are so many selection for you to choose from, and if this is not what you like, the Mardi Gras still have a few more specialty restaurants to offer. The sea is all around you when you cruise, and it has something for all your senses to experience. From the scent of a sea breeze to the sound of waves lapping at the ship. Complete the experience with an evening of curated seafood flavors at Rudy's Sea Grill. Rudy's Sea Grill, located on Deck 8, open from 5:30 p.m. to 9:30 p.m. This restaurant is the brainchild of cookbook author and master chef Rudy Soderman. He has years of experience pleasing palates of vacationers. And this guy loves serving up a smile as much as Carnival does. There are different hidden messages under the dish. Don't forget to check out yours. The chef is serious about you experiencing the best that the seas have to offer. And an evening at Rudy's proves it through the courses. And this is what we had tonight, starting with Coquille Saint-Jacques. I love this one so much. It's scallop, gratinated cheese sauce and Parmesan crumbs. Next appetizer is wild-caught tuna. It's raw tuna, red onions, kimchi emulsion and lemon herb crisps. This one is really refreshing. Then the soup, chipino. It's mixed seafood stew and seafood bisque. Then comes to the main dish I had, crab stuffed lobster tail imperial. It comes with roasted carrot. And last the dessert, I had apple cheese cake and chocolate truffle cake. This restaurant was very busy the day I was there. I strongly suggest you to make a reservation as soon as you can. This is a 4-courses meal with the cost of $42 per person. It was very well worth it. Red Frog Tiki Bar. Sip a Polynesian punch, try a jungle bird, or get a little tongue-twisted ordering a Red's Rum Jumper. This poolside bar actually spans two decks from deck 16 to 17, and no matter where you are sailing, can be counted on to transport you right to the land of Tiki. Lido Marketplace. Be your own bartender, pour yourself a cold one and enjoy fresh beers any time of the day. All you need is your set sail pass. Serenity Bar. Serenity Bar is located in the adult-only section of the ship. Here, you can order your favorite drink and chill by the pool without the noise. Like being in a state of serenity. Bar Della Rosa. Bar serving both indoor and outdoor patrons. Thinking of Aperol Spritz, Bellini, or Espresso Martini. And you can also get a perfect cup of macchiato here. We ordered our morning coffee here every day. Guy's Pig and Anchor Smokehouse / Brewhouse. Let's talk beers. Their exclusive line of Parched Pig registered craft brews, a smoked porter, a farmhouse ale, a hoppy IPA, and a toasted amber is brewed under the supervision of a pro brewmaster. Just feet from your table. Want to tour the brewery? Or pick up a refillable growler? Go ahead. They also have some specialty cocktails that look and taste amazing. This one here is the Smoke Boulevardier. The Watering Hole. A poolside bar we're building for aficionados of backyard-style relaxation. There's not much people here, and we spend a lot of our time here in the evenings. Alchemy Bar. Unique vintage-themed cocktail pharmacy. All you need is a willingness to be surprised, to try something new. Select spirits, fresh juices, infused syrups, spices, and other tantalizing secrets performed before your very eyes by the true mixmasters, our bartenders. Choose a remedy from the menu, or let us prescribe you a custom elixir just for you. Havana Bar. A spot that's intriguing by night and friendly anytime. Step into the Havana Bar trademark and be transported to antebellum Cuba, preserved today in old postcards, vintage literature, and classic delicacies. Take in great ocean views as you try something authentically Cuban, like Café Cubano, that's Cuban coffee, or handcrafted Cuban cocktails, think daiquiris, mojitos, and more. And this spot definitely doesn't cool down when the sun goes down, with music and dancing keeping things hot well into the night. the Brass Magnolia. You can imagine this onboard bar at the intersection two of NOLA's most enduring icons, the city's indelible jazz nightlife and its historic garden district. The culture is well represented on board by the swinging jazz trio that keeps things nice and hot, and it only takes one look at the decor to feel as if you just stepped into an elegant southern estate. Fortune Teller Bar. The Victorian elegance and mysterious decor suggest a rich history, whisper a word about the mystical, and our crystal ball is reminding us to not forget the amazing cocktails. High spirits truly abound here, and fortune tellers' unnaturally talented bartenders would be pleased to conjure up recipes like the all-black new moon, that changes color before your eyes. The Golden Galaxy, this drink is actually made with a bit of authentic gold. Piano Bar. Pull up a seat, order your favorite cocktail, and let your friendly piano player know what you'd like to hear. Then join the sing-along for a hand-clapping, foot-tapping, finger-snapping good time. Grand View Bar and Central Stage Bar. These are the spots to get your drinks while watching shows and playing games in the atrium. In this video, we will be showing you the interior cabin room 15401. First off, this is our first time choosing an inside stateroom for a cruise. We were a bit excited and worried, but we wanted to try it anyways. Once we boarded the ship, we waited until 1:30 p.m. to enter our stateroom. The key cards were in an envelope at the front door. Using the key card, we entered the room and was greeted with a king-size bed. Behind us to the right, sits a working desk, shelves, TV, and a small refrigerator. We were surprised about how many outlets were available in this room. There were a total of 3 US outlets and a total of 6 USBs. One thing to note is that there are no European outlets like some other cruise ships. At the desk, you will find a telephone which you can call the guest service or order room service. Below the desk you can find a small refrigerator. It's very cold, unlike Royal Caribbean's cooler which they use. You can also find 3 drawers to store your belongings. The chair at the desk is also a convertible storage. If you have items that you would like to store away neatly during the cruise, this is an option. The closets here are nicely designed and offer a good amount of organization. There is also a cool option to create more shelves inside. You can find a digital safe and also some drawers to store your socks or underwear. Very nicely thought out. The bathroom is moderately sized and have the usual amenities. We didn't like the shower gel and shampoo much. It feels like glycerin and has that not completely washed off feeling. Luckily, we brought our own. But if you are into fruity smells, you might enjoy it. Overall, we enjoyed the room. The only thing that was problematic was not having natural light in the room. We couldn't tell if it was daytime or nighttime. One thing that helped was the television. You will be able to open a live feed camera that will help you be more aware of the time. I opened the live feed in full screen most of the day. You can also use the television to look up information. All the current activities will be shown. Or you can find out what restaurants are open at the time. What the overall itinerary is? Or even watch some movies. It is very nice that they have a selection of free on-demand movies. If you wanted to sit back and watch Maze Runner, it's available for free. Thank you for watching. I hope you enjoyed this tour of the Carnival Mardi Gras. Please don't forget to hit the subscribe button for up-to-date information on newest cruise ships. Happy cruising!